Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of DaVinci Resolve, that is version 19 on Windows operating system. So DaVinci Resolve is a very popular video editing tool. I extensively use it for editing my videos. So whatever videos you see on this channel, most of the videos I edit on DaVinci Resolve. It's a very useful tool. So if you want to edit videos, you can always use DaVinci. So in this video, I'm going to talk about how to install DaVinci, then how to use DaVinci, and all of that I'm going to show you on this video. So this video is going to be a bit long, but I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. So now do subscribe to our channel and also don't forget to comment. That will really motivate me to make more such videos. And I am also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there. If you have any questions, you can also ask me over there as well. I am definitely going to help you. Now to install DaVinci Resolve, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and you need to search over here DaVinci Resolve download and hit enter. So that's going to show you this www.blackmagicdesign.com as a first search result. So you need to click on this DaVinci Resolve 19. And it's going to redirect to the official site of DaVinci Resolve 19. So this is this link I'm going to provide right in your description. So once you are here, you need to just simply scroll down and you'll see that latest version is DaVinci Resolve 19. So you need to click on this free download now button and it's going to show you this screen. So here you'll see we have basically two versions, right? One is DaVinci Resolve 19, another is DaVinci Resolve Studio 19. So this Studio 19 is a bit pro version, so you need to purchase it in order to use all these features. But you can use DaVinci Resolve 19, which is totally free of cost. So you need to just simply click on, you know, this download button. So depending upon what operating system you're using, macOS, Linux, or Windows ARM, or Windows, you know, traditional 32-bit or 64-bit, you know, depending upon that, you need to switch to all these links. So now I'm going to click on this Windows x86. So if you are using 32-bit operating system or a 64-bit operating system, so it's going to support that. You need to fill all these details and then you need to register, and you can, you know, click on this register and download, and you'll be able to download the product. Alright, I have already downloaded it. You can see the same DaVinci Resolve 19 zip file, you know, is already been downloaded over here, and the file size is 2.25 gigabyte. So all you need to do is you need to just simply right click and then you need to click on extract all to extract all these files over here. So you can see it is rightly started extracting, and it has rightly extracted over here. So now you're going to see this exe. So I'll, you know, close this, I'll show you. So this is the extracted folder. So when you go inside that folder, you will get this DaVinci Resolve 19.0 windows.exe file. Alright, and again, file size is 2.25 of gigabyte. So you just simply double click on this exe to install it locally on your system. It's going to start extracting all the files. Let's wait for a minute. And after that, it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. So you need to click on yes. And there you go. So you can see DaVinci Resolve installer is rightly opened over here. So let's first minimize our download directory. And here you need to just simply click on install. So DaVinci Resolve is started installing. So welcome to DaVinci Resolve setup wizard. So just, you know, simply click on next. So these are all license agreement, you need to read this, you need to accept this and click on next. So this is where our DaVinci Resolve is going to be installed, which is totally fine. Just simply click on next. So see, it's ready to be installed. Click on install and there you go. You can see it is rightly started installing. So now let's wait for a couple of minutes. And there you go. So you can see that our DaVinci Resolve is rightly installed. So completed DaVinci Resolve setup. Just click on finish. And then it's going to set up, you know, Microsoft Visual C++. So again, let's wait for some time. And there you go. So you can see that our installation is rightly done. It is telling to restart our computer. So you need to just simply click on yes and restart your system. So after restarting your system, let's come back to this video again. So welcome back. So after successfully rebooting your system, you'll be again landed over to the desktop and you'll see this DaVinci Resolve desktop shortcut is also created. So let's just simply double click on it to start launching our DaVinci Resolve. So welcome to DaVinci Resolve 19. So you can read all these different tutorials over here. For now, I'll just simply click on continue. So great, you're almost there. So you can always click on this quick setup guide and you can get all the necessary tutorials. For now, I'm going to click on skip and start right now. I'm going to show you all the details in this video itself. You don't need to worry. Just follow this video. So DaVinci Resolve 19 is rightly started launching. And it has rightly launched. So here is our untitled project. So you can create a new project. So just simply click on new project and you need to give a project name. So let's give the project name as demo project. And let's click on create. And our project is rightly created over here, demo project. So now this is the interface of our DaVinci Resolve. So here you'll see all these different tabs. So we need to switch to this edit tab. And here you'll see that media pool. So you need to add your media over here and then you need to drag that to this timeline and then you need to edit. So I'm going to show you all of that. Let's first pick one video. So you can see I have one video lying over here. So I'll just simply drag that video and I'm going to paste that under this media pool. So do you want to change the frame rate? Yes. Change the frame rate, it's going to set automatically as per this video frame rate. So our video is slightly added over here. Let's drag this video to our timeline and you can see that our video is slightly added to our timeline. So you can always play this video. So our video is slightly started playing over this timeline. You can always expand this or you can shrink this as per your requirement. Now, let's see how you can edit this video. So let's first pause this video. I'll, expand this a little. So what I'm going to do is, let's say I want to cut this section. So from here till here, I want to cut. So I'll just put the pointer to that section from where you want to cut and then you need to click on this razor icon. All right. So after that, you need to select this portion. So now if you move the pointer, you can see that it is separated into two parts, right? So I'll move this pointer till here and let's say I want to cut it over here. So this portion I want to delete. So you need to just simply select this, just drag and select this and hit delete button on your keyboard and you'll be able to see that that portion is now removed and we have these two sections now. All right. Similarly, you can also edit the video. So you need to just expand this and you will see the video over here. You can always click on this arrow icon and then you can always drag this timeline to make the volume this decibel increase, or you can always shrink this, all that you can do. You can see the dB over here, right? So that's the decibel. Similarly, let's say you want to add one transition. So between these two video, let's say you want to add one transition over here. So how to add that? So for that, you need to go to effects and then you will see video transitions over here. So here you can see we have all these different transitions. Some of them are free, some of them are paid one. So I'll use this cross dissolve. So I'll just simply drag this and I'll just simply put it over here. So if I expand this, you can see right in middle we have this added, right, this transition. So you can always increase this or you can always shrink this depending upon your choice. I'll make something like this and I'll put the pointer right before that. I'm going to play the video and I'm going to show you the transition. So I'll put the pointer and you can see this cross dissolve is happening, right? So sometimes everything you won't be able to see live, but once when it get you render the final output, there you'll see properly everything is happening. All right, Similarly, you can also add some titles. So you need to go to title, you can drag this and you can, you know, type whatever you want. So you need to go to inspector and you can put whatever title you want, let's say Geeky Script, and let's change the color to black maybe. And you can see that it is rightly over here, right? This Geeky Script, so that is actually coming from here. You can also go to settings, increase this size and all that. You can move this position, all these things you can do. All right, you can play around with all these different tools that DaVinci Resolve is providing you for free of cost. So you can always, you know, use all these different tools, just play around with it and edit your video. All right, so I am going to show you how you can export this. Once you are done with all this, you need to go to this export tab and then you need to provide a file name. So let's give the file name something like demo video, and you can choose what type of format you would like to, you know, get that video. So you can choose YouTube, Vimeo, all these, you know, different things. You can also choose the format from here, and you can also choose the resolution. You can get the output on 4K format as well, you know, all these things different you can do. You can choose the frame rate as well. All right, so after, you know, selecting all these different, you know, configurations, then you need to click on add to render queue. So that's going to show you this window, so where you are, you would like to save. Let's go to desktop and click on save. So on our desktop I'm saving the video, so you can see it is rightly added under job 1. So when you click on render all, it's going to start rendering the video. You can see render is process and it's going to take about three minutes. It's a small video, so on my system it's going to take around 3 minutes. All right, and you'll get the output. So in this way you can easily install DaVinci Resolve. I have showed you how to edit the video, some of the things I have showed you. If you need a detailed video, you can always mention on our comment sessions. I'm going to happily make a very detailed dedicated video on DaVinci Resolve. So, you know, just comment me. If I'm getting significant amount of comment, then definitely I'm going to make a dedicated video about DaVinci Resolve as well. So now that's basically all about this video. Please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I'm posting lot of videos, coding related videos mainly. So you can always subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Script vlogging channel. So I'm making lot of videos on traveling. So recently you can see these videos also I have edited on DaVinci Resolve. So all these different tricks, you know, I can always teach you. So you need to just simply comment in our comment sessions and I'm going to, you know, make those videos as well. All right, so you know, that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do follow me on Instagram as well, and if you are having any questions you can also ask me over there. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.